Welcome everybody to sessions focused on the operations platform for on-premise centric customers. My name is Stefan Lahr. I'm working for SAP Digital Business Services. And for this session, I have prepared the following agenda. First of all, I would start with an introduction to focused RUN. I see still a lot of confusion on customer side regarding this product, so I would like to spend a little bit more time here and try to clarify especially the differences to Solution Manager here. Then I will continue with some words regarding the functional scope so that you can see what is included and also what is not included, give you an overview of the architecture of focused RUN, and finally also will tell you what would be the right steps to go in the journey to potentially implement focused RUN in your site, on company side. Good, this is the plan. So let me start. First of all, what is focused RUN? As I said, I see quite a lot of confusion still in the market, even if this product exists already since more than 3 years. And this is mainly related to the official name. So I'm really not happy with this official name, but it is as it is, and it is named Focused RUN for SAP Solution Manager. It belongs to the Focused Solutions family, where you also know we have currently three products that belongs to this group. This is Focused Insights, Focused Build, and Focused RUN. And now it is so that Focused Insights, as well as Focused Build, are add-ons to Solution Manager. This means you have to have Solution Manager, and then you can install Focused Insights or Focused Build on top of it. Focused RUN not. Focused RUN is not an add-on to Solution Manager. So in fact, there is no way that you come from a Solution Manager, whatever version, via upgrading or migrating or installing something on top to a Focused RUN system. Focused RUN is an independent product, and this needs to be installed isolated from a Solution Manager. The Solution Manager is not a prerequisite at all to install Focused RUN. This is very important to understand. Of course, you can operate the Solution Manager and Focused RUN in parallel, but they do not influence each other, and they are not depending on each other. Two independent products. From the functionality point of view, we are speaking about a spin-off of Solution Manager functionality. And this means the functionality that you know from Solution Manager under the term application operation, the RUN segment of Solution Manager. These functionalities we have redeveloped on a new architecture. And this is focused RUN. And now you come by the question normally very fast, why did we do so? And the reason is quite easy. We have seen customer requirements that could not be satisfied with the Solution Manager anymore. These requirements were going in the direction of amount of systems that customer wants to connect to Solution Manager and do system monitoring for disconnected systems. No? There were customers asking us if it's possible to connect 2,000 systems to Solution Manager. In fact, that's not a good idea. No? Then data volume that needs to be handled, but also requirements regarding specific use cases that would require a very fast data volume handling and also the possibility to handle a very big data volume in real time, for example. And for all this, the Solution Manager architecture is showing some limitations. And with this focused RUN product, we came over these limitations, and we can offer this now to our customers. Also important to know, Focused RUN is a HANA-only product. This means you need to have the HANA database, and Focused RUN is only running together with this HANA database. It's a big difference also to Solution Manager, which is still an AnyDB release. During this transformation, during this redevelopment of the functionalities, these technical functionalities, these application operations functionalities, we have implemented a lot of improvements. These are improvements in the direction of automation. So we have automated managed system configuration, technical monitoring configuration completely. We have completely changed the agent infrastructure. We also have automated there the distribution of the agents. And I will give some more details when we come to the architectural section there. We also have changed the way how Focus Run communicates with the new developed agents. So this is a change in the direction of security. We have a clear data separation implemented, which is especially required for a service provider scenario, for example, and so on. There is one disadvantage, and this is Focus Run is not free of charge. So everyone who wants to use Focus Run has to acquire a sufficient license to run this product. And if you have maybe heard that for Focus Insights and Focus Build, the license will become part of the maintenance in 2020, Focus Run not. Focus Run remains to be licensed. Okay. As I said, I wanted to spend a little bit more time here on this first slide because I still see this confusion. I hope now it is more or less clear. Coming to the next question then, for customers, when to use Solution Manager and when to use Focus Run. And the first criteria, or what I haven't mentioned so far, is both are on-premise products. So this means the scope for both of it are SAP or the SAP's on-premise-centric customers. This means the majority of your SAP systems you have on-premise. Then you have to make the decision if you are using Solution Manager for the operations part or if you are using Focus Run for it. And there are some soft criteria, some hard criteria. Let me mention some of them. I said already we have practically an unlimited scalability on Focus Run. This means we are able to connect 20,000 systems to one single Focus Run and do system monitoring for these 20,000 systems. And this is not just marketing. This we do in the HANA Enterprise Cloud internal at SAP. So we reached already these dimensions. And we can really do so. So there is no clear limitations from the amount of systems that should give you now the decision point from now on. If I add one more system to my solution manager, then I should switch to Focus Run. But we see that in the area of a couple of hundred systems, we see that some architecture limitations, let's say. In general, it is every time so if you are satisfied with your solution manager, even if you have 1,000 systems connected, if you can work with the applications anyway with a sufficient performance, if you have a sufficient stability of the environment, and if you are satisfied with the applications that are currently provided by solution manager in the area of application operations, then there is no need for you to think about Focus Run or switching to Focus Run. And in opposite, if you are not satisfied with solution manager, if you see performance problems that cannot be solved by configuration changes or other optimizations, if you anyway have already split your solution manager, also this we see very frequently on customer sides that they start to operate two solution manager because they have problems with, from the organizational structuring between the complexity of the solution manager that includes the build segment, service desk, project documentation, change request management. In this area, usually have a very low demand of frequently updating the system. And then you have to handle this with the more run-related features and functions, where you have a very frequent demand on changing and updating the system. And then you have to plan the downtime accordingly. This affects the work from another area and so on. And therefore, we see customers that have now more than one solution manager, one for the operations part, one for the more project-related and build part. And of course, in this case, it's also absolutely valid to replace the solution manager that you use for your application operations by a Focus Run system to get all the advantages of the automation, of the higher performance, of the stability, and so on. And the last point that I also want to mention, it's not every time the system, the amount of systems or the data volumes that needs to be handled or the stability of the landscape. It's also if you want to use the newest applications and use cases from SAP, which are going in the direction of artificial intelligence, system anomaly prediction, and so on. These functionalities you will find only on Focus Run and not on Solution Manager. Okay. What is the functional scope? As I said already, in scope of Focus.RAN are the technical aspects. So this means the support for the administration of a modern system landscape that consists of systems on-premise and applications in the cloud. We call it a hybrid landscape. And we have structured now the Focus.RAN functionalities in several groups. The first group is named Advanced System Management. And here we offer functionality that gives support to administrate all the systems on-premise. What it is in detail, I will show you after this slide. Then we have the second group. This is the Advanced User Monitoring. Here we try to provide you with features and functions that allows to monitor if a certain application is available and responds with good performance, no matter if this application runs on the systems on-premise or it is a public cloud application, for example. The third core functionality or group of functionalities we have named Advanced Integration Monitoring. Here we offer features and functions that you can use to monitor connectivity between the systems, performance of the connectivity, also to monitor message flows and data transfers in your system landscape. Surrounded are these groups by the Advanced Configuration Monitoring, the Advanced Event and Alert Management. Also here, we have a central alert inbox where all the events from all the different use cases are finally getting prominent and has to be or can be handled in from this central point. And we have the Advanced Root Cause Analysis. And overall, the functionality, we have the so-called Advanced Analytics and Intelligence. Here we bundle this as a term, which is valid for all the applications in Focus.RAN. So whenever we see that a new cutting-edge technology makes sense to be implemented in Focus.RAN, we evaluate this new technology and we implement this. So we have, for example, a metric forecast. We have system anomaly analysis. I will give you later also in this direction some more examples. And that's it. This is the scope of Focus.RAN. As you can see, the technical aspects, the application operations aspects. So you will not find on Focus.RAN service desk, change request management, project documentation, and so on. This is not in scope and will not come into scope. Huh? We want to get rid of this complexity. We want to keep it slim, efficient, with highest performance, highest degree of automation. This is our goal for this product. Okay, let me go into the details. So for the advanced system management, as I said already, the core functionality here, I think, is the system monitoring. So system monitoring, from the look and feel, you will see there's no big difference to the solution manager system monitoring or technical monitoring application, as it is named there. The difference or the technology that we are using is the same, SAP UI5 for all the UIs. The differences are then in the details. Like I said, on system monitoring, I can show you screenshots from thousands of connected systems and showing the data in the system monitoring. Such a screenshot I would not get from a solution manager. Right? Besides that, we have open component monitoring included in Focus.RAN as a dedicated application to give a low barrier monitoring of unmodeled systems and services as a possibility. This means we are fully aware that on customer side, the landscape is not 100% consisting only of SAP components, SAP systems. It's most of the time a mixture between SAP and third-party components. And here, our template concept would not be sufficient, as well as we do not have a possibility to get a model in the landscape management database of Focus.RAN to include this from a model point of view. Anyway, we want to give you the possibility to monitor, for example, third-party host availability, URL availability, script execution, log file monitoring, and so on. I want to show you this live on the system, that you get an impression from this open component monitoring to get away a little bit from the PowerPoint only show. This is live. So I have opened already the open component monitoring, and you see here in the first screen, if I open this menu, all the capabilities that we are currently offering. So starting on the top with the URL availability monitoring, then URL HTTPS certificate validation monitoring, host availability, TCP port availability, RFC availability. We can monitor if certain Windows services have been started, stopped, or in the running mode. The same we can do for operating system processes. So whatever third-party applications that you have running on a dedicated host, we can at least monitor that the process of it on operating system level is up and running. And this most of the time gives you already a good indication that this application can also be used. We have now, with the newest release, also included operating system script monitoring. This means whatever you have in your mind that you can program as an operating system script and brings back any value, we can monitor for this value, and we can make you aware of any deviation of the expected value. This is it's a functionality that offers a very wide potential for third-party monitoring, since the flexibility is only limited by your programming capabilities. We can monitor every return code from the script and can trigger an alert out of this. And we have this log file monitor, so we are searching in log files for certain patterns, certain buzzwords that you want to get aware of via the alerting and open component monitoring. If we go, just to show you some examples how this looks like away from the overview, going to the URL availability, very easy to configure. We have a hands-on session here where we do this with the participants. This is an exercise that takes something like 3 minutes, I would say, maximum, to select a certain URL and monitor this URL by pinging to this URL, monitoring the HTTP response code, giving it a status rating, and then present this in this application. You can monitor google.com if this is available, and so every application in your environment, every third-party application that has an HTTP access point on, for example. The next thing, also quite easy to explain, is the host availability. Here we also send a ping via the network to a certain host and monitor the response. If the response is OK, then we say, OK, from a network point of view, host ABC is available, and whatever is on this host, then maybe two. For the host monitoring, URL availability monitoring, as well as the TCP port availability monitoring, we do not even an agent installed on the third-party component. We are using one agent that is anywhere in the landscape on an SAP component, and then we can give it a task to send this ping from this agent to any third-party host that is available from the network point of view and monitor then the response. For the other features like Windows service, yes? No, we have one agent per host on SAP components. But from one dedicated agent, we can now monitor several hosts, third-party hosts, if they are available from the network point of view. For the Windows servers monitoring, as well as for the operating system process monitoring, of course, we need an agent on the third-party host, because otherwise we cannot get to this data. We monitor here, as I said already, if the Windows service is started, stopped, or in the running mode, give the rating accordingly. Same also for the operating system processes. The last example that I wanted to show, operating script execution. From the UI, also very unspectacular. You let a certain script running, and we monitor for the return code. The return code is the trigger for the status evaluation, and whatever you bring back, you get aware of a critical situation, or you know that everything is expected as you have programmed in your script. Good. With this, going back to the PowerPoints, giving you a glimpse of other features. We have now also included here monitoring of SAP standard jobs in FocusRAN. We have the IT calendar, we have the work mode management, we have the service availability management, we have fully automated system health checks. This means according to the system type, so if this is ABAP system, J2E system, we have predefined checks in so-called guided procedures that you can, during the configuration, assign to a certain amount of systems in your landscape. You can decide how often they should be executed and who should get the result of the execution. And this means, for example, every morning your system administrator will find a report execution, an execution report in the inbox, and sees exactly on system ABC a certain check has been failed. You can imagine like an early watch alert that you can fully configure. You know, early watch alert is hard-coded, all the criteria here, you have the full flexibility. You can also go activate, deactivate certain steps. If you know the guided procedure framework, the guided procedure concept, you also know that you can fully edit the guided procedures that are delivered from SAP. So you can create your own steps, your own checks, you can manipulate the ones that comes from SAP. Also here, you are only limited from the ABAP coding point of view. And last but not least, also the license and maintenance certificate management is part of FocusRAN, as well as the support for the maintenance planner and SAP early watch alert. With this, we are coming to the second group, advanced user monitoring. Here we have two applications. One you know from Solution Manager, that is named User Experience Monitoring or End User Experience Monitoring. Here in FocusRAN, we have changed the name. The concept is exactly the same. It is synthetic user monitoring. Previously recorded scripts that you have edited in an editor tool to be able to execute this automatically is distributed to decentralized robots, which is nothing else than agents. And these agents are executing now this previously recorded scripts frequently and send you the response or the result of the response. This means certain scenario step is available, has been answered with a good performance, and also from the content point of view, it is correctly. Now, this gives you all the 24/7 monitoring over the recorded scenarios, no matter if there is a real user doing some activities on your systems or not. And you get the chance to react, even if there is no business time, for example. This is synthetic user monitoring, as I said, exists since 10 years at least, I think, on Solution Manager, and we have fully taken over this concept. Whenever I have presented this synthetic user monitoring from a Solution Manager, then the next request from the audience was, this is good, but I will never be able to script all the different scenarios that my end users in the organization are doing. So what I really want, whenever a user is doing and creates a request that is handled by my system landscape, I want to know exactly on which system, on which system components, and how long did it take on each of the components. We could not implement such use case on Solution Manager because you can imagine, just if we speak about maybe, just to give a number, 200 concurrent users that are really doing exactly in the same moment of time an activity. The data volume is significant, and we need to evaluate this data volume then in real time. So we decided not to do so on Solution Manager. On FocusRAN, we do not have problems with data volume handling or real-time data evaluation at all. We are HANA-based. HANA has been built for such use cases. So we are offering here the real user monitoring as an application that allows you to monitor really each single user request execution in your system landscape. We gather the data, we correlate the data so that we later on can show you a request flow diagram where you see exactly in which component, on which components your requests have been executed. Also, this I would like to show you live on the system. I think then you get the best impression. Then just explaining it. That's the real user monitoring application. Monitoring of HTTPS requests, RFC requests, Fiori requests, WebDimpo requests, HTTP requests, and dialog requests. All this is possible. You get statistical information about the amount of requests per system in the overview screen. And if you drill down now, for example, to the Fiori requests, you see for the time frames that you have selected how many Fiori applications have been executed over the last 1 hour, for example, by how many users, what was the average response time for each of the applications, how many total executions you had, and how many red-rated executions, which means the response time was above the thresholds that you have defined for these applications. Then you can drill down for Fiori. The next step is to show the request action. This means the component of the Fiori application that has been clicked by the end user. So it's also a possibility to monitor user behavior here and usage of your applications, just pausing the automated refresh. And from here, then, we can go deeper with the analysis, see at which point in time a certain click has been executed. And finally, if we select one of the points in time, then we get this request execution diagram. Let me zoom in a little bit. I don't want to give too many details now. But what we see here, the blue frame tile, this is the starting point. This is representation of the end user in the Fiori scenario. We can make the information bigger. I see here now I have selected one that is working with a mobile device because he is using Android operating system in version 9. He has used the Chrome browser in version 76 to trigger this request. It was 3.2 seconds running on his mobile device, 0.2 seconds on the device itself. It has triggered two round trips. Round trip time was 2.8 seconds. Network time 1.5 seconds, and so on. And now I can follow these two round trips here also in the diagram. I see now here one of the round trips has been executed in your system landscape on system FT4 ADM. And even for this system, then I see here the username. This is by default decoded, or this is depending on the authorization that you have as the user of this application, because not in every country and not every work council likes to see this degree of information. But we have it, so you can enable it. And then you see on the system the response time, the net time of the system, CPU consumption, database time, wait time, memory consumption. And you also see that this request to be really fulfilled has triggered two more RFC requests that were then handled on father systems and components and so on. So at the end, you bring this complete picture together and you see exactly on which component you have to drill deeper down to make a proper root cause analysis for a certain scenario. And this works, of course, also if your end users are calling you and tell you 20 minutes ago the system was slowly, or I had problems 1 hour ago, which is very common. Huh? Then you have no chance with starting tracing or do something else because the situation is gone. And you have no other possibilities and hope that with the next time you catch it or it will never appear again, whatever is your strategy then. Here you can monitor 24/7 every single user request execution. You go back 20 minutes in time, check for the user, and you see exactly which request he has been executed and what was the performance on each of the components. This works from the UI point of view for SubGUI. WebDimpo, WebGUI, ZapUI 5, as I have shown to you here. From the back end point of view, SAP Gateway, ABAP, J2E systems, and now with the newest release, also for the cloud platform. This means if you have an own developed application on SAP cloud platform, using a browser to access the data there, we can monitor end to end. So from the browser via your application to the cloud platform services that you have been using, or your application has been using, down to a potential backend, which is also a cloud component. So very powerful tool. I have customers, and I'm in contact with customers that have acquired the license of Focusrun only for this use case. Good, but that's not all. So we have the advanced integration monitoring as part of Focusrun. Here we have functionalities and applications, that allows you to do message flow monitoring, PI message flow monitoring, IDOC monitoring, monitoring of exceptions from cloud applications, as well as performance from cloud applications in a so-called scenario monitoring. This is our application that covers the most of the hybrid scenarios, features and functions, or the support that you need for hybrid scenarios. Also here, do not be mistaken, huh? We also have a PI message flow monitoring and solution manager. But if I go on site to a customer and implement their PI message flow monitoring, and I'm spending a lot of time with him discussing what are the most important message flows. Can he identify this? Which are the most important ones for the core business process? And only this one, then, I assign to be monitored by the solution manager. And the reason is I want to keep the data volume as low as possible. On Focusrun, I don't have any problems with data volume. So we go on customer side, we monitor everything, and then we tell to the customer, put a filter on top, bring it into a scenario context, bring it into a business context, so that you limit down then the or that you make handleable the information that you get from all this monitoring. So we are really able to monitor millions of interfaces and message flows. And one more sentence regarding this. If you go on Solution Manager, monitor a certain PI message flow, we show you over the last 1 hour, 1,000 messages has been executed with good performance. That's it. In Focusrun, you can drill down then in each of the executed messages, and you can see where it has been executed, what was the performance on each of the components. And this you can do for every message execution, so not just for the successful ones, especially also for the ones that have been ended with an error. So you get a much finer granularity of data also with this Focusrun system. Then the next one, we have the advanced event and alert management. As I said already, the core component here is an alert inbox. We have surrounded this alert inbox with new developed dashboards that shows statistical information regarding which components are triggering the most of alerts, which components are affected by the most of the alerts, how long a certain alert is already open in the alert inbox without that someone has assigned an activity to it, so a kind of monitoring of the how effective your support organization is working. And it shows, of course, all the alerts from all the different use cases that we have in Focusrun. So user monitoring, integration monitoring, system monitoring, and so on. Everything comes together in one single place. And here you can analyze it. You can see which metric is responsible for it. You can assign fully automated guided procedures as an alert follow-up activity. So also here you are only limited to the ABAP coding potential that you have in your environment. Also important to know from the outbound integration point of view, Focusrun is not offering by itself a ticket system or an ITSM solution, but of course you can propagate a certain event to the outside world via SNMP trap or via creating a ticket in service desk of solution manager or any other third-party ITSM solution. A big difference here also to Solution Manager is that we have an inbound integration as well. And this means if you have a third-party monitoring tool like Nagios, something that works on IT infrastructure layer, that is not covered by SAP, not by Solution Manager, also not by Focusrun. All the network components, we do not have an agent for it, like router, bridges, switches, but also telephones, printers, and so on. So I have seen a lot of stuff that customers are monitoring. If such a tool is propagating the information or has the potential to propagate this information to the outside world, you can send this to a web service of Focusrun, and we can consume this. And whenever we get data, we trigger an event in the alert inbox of Focusrun. And then you can see that printer ABC doesn't have enough paper. And it's an alert like anyone else in the focus transistor. And you can assign then a follow-up method or a guide procedure to it, and so on. So it's fully integrated then in our tool. Good. We have the advanced configuration monitoring here. You most likely also know from Solution Manager that we have change analysis, change the configuration validation, change analysis, and change reporting. I think it's still distributed, even in some different dashboards in Solution Manager. Here we have combined this in one application. And the biggest change that we have done here, since we do not have BW, or since we do not use BW in Focus-Run anymore, everything is HANA-based, that we have now a very simple functionality to create own policies, own set of rules that you want to have validated against the configuration settings in your system environment. It's in fact three lines of XML coding that you do there, and then you find out if all your databases are installed on a certain support package level, for example. We have a lot of predefined policies, set of rules that we ship already. You can fully maintain this, edit the scripts that we ship to you. You can create your own ones. This is not just working for the technical parameter validation, but also for security-relevant parameters. For example, you can run a report that shows you who has sub-all authorizations in your entire system landscape. Good. The last use case that I have mentioned is the advanced root cause analysis. Here we have fully new developed dashboards and views based on the feedback that we got from Solution Manager users that you are satisfied or that you are expecting a higher level of personalization options, especially for the root cause analysis functionality. We have fully opened this application here. So it is possible that you create your own dashboard, you drag and drop a certain view on it, and you decide which type of metrics and KPIs you want to see on it, for which time frame, with which graphical representation, and so on. So you can easily create a dashboard that shows you one metric in two different views with two different time frames, for example. That's not really possible with Solution Manager, right? The views are interactive, so you can drill down in a certain set of data. We have predefined views of the, from our point, most important metrics and KPIs according to the system type. So you find special content for HANA databases, for ABAP systems, J2E systems, but also for some third-party component like the Apache Tomcat and so on. Very new here also is, also here we have opened our application. And this means with a so-called open KPI store view, we are able now to consume any metric from the outside world. So any number that you send to Focus-Run, to this web service, it's possible to create a view on it and to analyze it in this application. And this means if you have a sensor somewhere in your environment, IT, Internet of Things, IT/OT components, or if you have a weather station, or whatever you have in your mind, we can bring this information into Focus-Run, you can create your view on it, and you can analyze it with this tool. We see a big potential here. We are just on the starting point with this opening now, but the feedback so far that I got from customers is very, very positive. Beside the system analysis application, two more applications are belonging to this group. This is the end-to-end trace analysis functionality and the file system browser. File system browser allows you to get from the central Focus-Run system direct access to a certain log file on a managed object. You can view the content. You can download the content for your analysis. And the end-to-end trace analysis, I think you also know it from Solution Manager, allows you, if case that you have a reproducible performance problem, to trace a certain activity. And in the evaluation, you can data mine exactly how much time for this certain activity has been spent in the browser, for example, in the network, in the ABAP system, in the J2E system, in the database, and according to the system type, in a certain function module, or how much time has been spent in a certain Java class or method. Then this is the trace functionality. We have also adapted this on Focustron. Good. The last one is not a real use case, as I said, but this is more a concept that you find in all the applications of Focustron. So we have now also implemented certain analytics functionalities. This means cross applications dashboard, tactical dashboards, operation control center dashboards that allows you to combine the information of several applications, like a view from user monitoring with a view from system monitoring combined with a view from integration monitoring on one single dashboard. That's possible now. And we also have the adaption of this newest technologies, as I already have said, by the forecast of a certain metric. This means in a system monitoring application, you can go to every metric, click on an icon, and then the system shows you the most likely behavior of this metric for the next 30 minutes. 30 minutes is our default. You can adjust this. But according to our experience, with this, you reach the highest degree of accuracy. You come the closest to the reality, let's say. So for 30 minutes, this works quite well. And we also have system anomaly prediction implemented. This means for monitored HANA databases, we can predict if the system is running into hanging situations or out of memory situations. Based on pattern recognition models that we have created on our data that we have collected in the HANA Enterprise Cloud environment, as I said, around about 20,000 systems. So we have really a huge volume of data that we can analyze and where we can train artificial intelligence algorithms to really identify certain metrics which are a good indicator that in the next 20 minutes, 30 minutes, a HANA database runs into a critical situation. We have defined these models now. We ship these models. And you can use these models then out of the box on your side and in your environment. Good. We have a lot of plans on Focustron. This you see here on the roadmap. So especially also in this area of artificial intelligence, pattern recognition, and so on. I don't want to go over all the points of the slide. Just to give you some highlights, we are working now on alert correlation. This means we are fully aware that in case that you get a non-availability alert on a host, this has, as a follow-up, you will most likely get also a non-availability alert on a certain instance from a system that is installed also on one of this or on this host that is not available. So you get a second alert. Maybe you have two instances which are not available, then you get a third alert. This has an effect to your integration monitoring, potentially, where you get also then maybe a yellow alert or maybe also a red alert to your user monitoring, fifth alert. So you have a bunch of alerts which are all related to one single source. We want to correlate this. We want to make you aware only of the root cause of the problem so that you can handle such an alert much more efficient. We also think in the direction of getting away from the from this predefined threshold settings, from this template concept. Imagine if you would install Focustron in your system landscape. You let it run for 3 to 5 days, and Focustron learns by itself what is the smooth behavior, what is the normal behavior of your system landscapes, of all these different metrics that are collected, and sets all the thresholds accordingly by its own. It saves a lot of time that you spend now with adjusting the template settings, bringing this to your specific situation. Let the system learn this by itself. And then these become much more efficient. So this is part of it. Also in the area of automation, we have a lot of plans. You see the roadmap is full, planned until 2021 here. And you can expect much, much more functionality in this regard. Good. Coming to the architecture, I want to give you a high-level overview and point out the most important differences, especially to the solution manager here. You see already on the bottom, the technology foundation that Focus Run consists only of the HANA database and the NetWeaver ABAP stack. Currently, NetWeaver 7.5.1 or 2, I think, is the one that we are supporting now. And that's it. So you see no J2E engine, for example. Focus Run is not using the NetWeaver J2E engine. On top of this, then, the application foundation, even if you know the name and if you know the functionality, keep in mind that we have really redeveloped all this functionality so that these applications, these functionalities, can be work perfectly together with HANA. And this you only reach if you change the coding of an application. And we cannot do so on Solution Manager because Solution Manager is, from a legal point of view, labeled as an AnyDB release. So we cannot offer any functionality on top of Solution Manager that would only work if you have Solution Manager installed on HANA. You could really complain about this, and we would have to make it, we would have to ensure that every application is also working with all the supported databases here. Here we only have HANA supported, and that's why we can fully optimize all the applications to this database technology. So we have the landscape management database also on Focus Run. This is the entity that keeps the model of the entire managed system landscapes, and it's filled up with inside discovery by the SLD data suppliers and outside discovery via the SAP host agent. We have completely changed the agent structure of Focus Run. You know the diagnostics agent of Solution Manager. It's a component that you have to install separately. It occupies something like 1 GB in the file system, comes with its own SID. And from time to time, one or another complains about stability. We have analyzed what we really need for our use cases. We have eliminated everything else. And we have developed a so-called simple diagnostics agent. Here we speak about 200 megabytes binaries that are transported from the Focus Run system to an existing SAP host agent, if the host agent is connected. And then the host agent is responsible for the installation, starting, stopping, and maintenance of this simple diagnostics agent, fully automated without manual interaction. And this, this solves a lot of problems and gives us, for example, also the possibility to recognize if a certain simple diagnostics agent is not sending data anymore. The system could send a trigger to the host agent to simply restart simple diagnostics agent. If the restart helps and it continues to work, no manual interaction was necessary to solve the problem, fully automated as well. Then we have the monitoring and alerting infrastructure. Also for Focus Run, we still deliver all the templates, have defined the most important matrix KPIs for all the supported products. From the supported products point of view, we have a similar coverage than Solution Manager has this. So of course, also with Focus Run, it's possible to monitor an Oracle database, an IBM database, and so on. Then we have the simple system integration. This is our application that replaces managed system configuration, technical monitoring configuration completely. In Focus Run, this has been also fully automated. So if you have a connected ABAP system, you give a user and password in this application for the connectivity. And then all the template assignment, data collection, structuring, and configuration, all this is done automatically in the background. Once this job finishes, you see the monitored values in the system monitoring UI. And what I also have mentioned already, guided procedure framework, we have also adapted on Focus Run. Here we are using fully automated guided procedures for system health checks, for alert reaction methods, and so on. On top then, the different use cases that I just have shown you before. To summarize this, we have one more slide. before I come to this. Also a big change is from the communication point of view. So FocusRAN communicates with the simple diagnostics agent only via HTTP/HTTPS connectivity. This means if you change something in the template, for example, we push this data to the simple diagnostics agent. Agent collects the information according to the template settings and push this data back to FocusRAN via HTTP/HTTPS only. Do not underestimate this. I was, now it's 3-4 weeks ago in India in a conference, and there I was listening to a big service provider who was on stage, and he was speaking about the experience that he has now with FocusRAN, and he said that they came down from more than 9,000 open firewall ports to less than 10 via this concept. This is related, no RFC, no RMI, no native DB connections. All this we don't need anymore. And we only push the data. We push the information from FocusRAN to the agent, and the agent pushed the information back. So on FocusRAN side, we only need to write down the data. And HANA is very, very efficient in just writing down the data. So this is very easy for us. In Solution Manager, we do this push and pull. You know, when you do a pull, you have to wait for the data. Maybe it doesn't come in time. You have to pull again. Then it is overlapping with the previous pull signal and so on. So it has been causing a lot of problems. That's why we also have eliminated this here. Now, the summarization of this concept. You see from the technical footprint point of view, we have extremely simplified the architecture. So we have removed the J2E stack, the BW, we don't need the CRM, so no CRM, no DBA cockpit, no extractor framework, even the system landscape directory is optional. So it's possible to connect the SLD data suppliers direct to the LMDB of FocusRAN if you want so. Communication I have just mentioned, so no RFC, no native DB, no RMI, you can close all these ports on your firewall. You're using HTTPS, or if you are using HTTPS, then you can fully encode the communication, so this is also a big plus from the security point of view. We also have implemented a clear separation of the data. So we have an identifier that gives us a clear indication to which customer a certain set of metrics is belonging to. This is especially interesting for service providers who has to serve hundreds of customers. We can at every moment in time identify exactly from which customer a certain metric is coming, because we store the metric together with this identifier in the HANA DB, and then later on with authorizations, it is possible for the service provider to give access to the central FocusRAN system to certain clients. They can access the functionality, and we ensure that they can only see the systems and data of the systems which are belonging to their organization. We see now service providers that create totally different business concept out of this, because they charge customers additional for the real user monitoring, for example, as an additional service for certain systems, and they charge them with a specific amount of dollars per month to use this functionality on FocusRAN. Some numbers regarding the scalability performance. I said already 20,000 systems is proved by the reality. In fact, we don't know there's a limitation. We will monitor this now on the hack environment. So far, so good. We also don't think that in the near future any customer will come in this dimension. So let's see. From this point of view, we can practically say it's unlimited scalability. Performance increasement, data throughput increasement, and we reach also the same result with less data footprint. This is related to evaluation against the basket of other database vendors against HANA. And we also use FocusRAN HANA database compression, so that this is really to your advantage and to help with this decreased data footprint. And in the lowest section, then the automation, mainly related to the change of the agent concept. You can imagine the simple diagnostics agent now as a plug-in of the host agent, fully handled by the host agent. We have automated the preparation on the managed system side. And we also can react fully automatic to reconfiguration of the system landscape. This means if you add a certain instance, then we get a trigger in the LMDB of Focusrun. The trigger then the simple system integration, assigning the templates again, setting all the data collection, setting the data collection frequency, setting the agents to collect the data. All this fully automated, so that without manual interaction, you see then the monitored values in the system monitoring UI for this new instance. Okay. How to get and implement Focusrun? We have a relatively clear, straightforward process. If a customer is interested in Focusrun, we are offering a one-hour introduction session. This is more or less exactly what you have here today and now. It's the introduction, general overview, especially the difference to Solution Manager. This is the scope of this session. Then, if the customer is interested, we come to the next step, which is a so-called Focusrun positioning workshop. This we can do on-site, we can do remote. If you do it remote, you have to calculate with around about 4 hours for this session. There we go into the deep details. We go over all the different applications, show as much as possible live on a system, make you fully aware of the functionality. We also go in deep details in the architecture, explaining you how we do the data separation, how is this new agent concept working, and so on, so that you have a full understanding. At the end, we collect data from your side regarding, or we need this data to calculate later on your hardware sizing and your HANA used memory consumption. This is the thing, the HANA used memory is the basis for the license fee. So it's not a user-based license. Here you pay for what you are using. And this means the amount of data that you are collecting and for how long you want to keep the data in the HANA database of Focusrun. For this, you have to pay the license fee. So we collect this data. As a follow-up of this positioning workshop, you get a presentation from us where you find the recommended hardware sizing, the amount of HANA used memory, which you give to your account executive. He will create then an offer based on dollars or euros. And according to the negotiations that you do with your account executives, then so with this, we do not have that much to do. And then you have all the numbers transparent in your organization. And then you come to a decision. Once you decide to go for Focusrun, you pay the license fee, you can download the software from the service marketplace, start with the implementation. We offer additional workshops then, and full support, of course. All this information can be also found on the web page. I have added this here to the slide so that you can get there direct in contact with us. Some marketing phrases. I think I have used them all. From the configuration point of view, it's more or less the same effort because it comes predefined. We have predefined what should be monitored, with which threshold, with which alert creation methods in the templates. So once you are using the default templates, this works out of the box for everything. If you come to the question, how is the effort to configure the landscape, the managed object landscape, to be ready for Focusrun? Also, this is quite easy, because you only have to ensure that the SAP host agent is on a sufficient patch level, which is at least patch level 18. I think we are now in the market with 40, 42. So if you have frequently updated the host agent, you are already good from this point of view. And then you have to ensure that the inside and outside discovery is working. So this means if you have an existing system landscape directory, you can switch on the bridging. So you can further use it for your existing solution manager. Enable the bridging so that the SLD sends the data not only to solution manager, but also to the LMDB of Focusrun. It's the easiest way. If not, as I said, it's optional. You can go direct to each of the system on ABAP system RC70, which is the data supplier, and let this point to the LMDB or focused one. And then it's done. So more or less the same. The effect is in, if you connect more and more systems, that the full configuration of managed system configuration and technical monitoring configuration, this is fully automated on Focused RAN. On Solution Manager, you have to go over, for managed system configuration, over a guided procedure of something like 10 steps. And then you go into the next guided procedure for the technical monitoring configuration, also something like 9 steps. And you have to do this manually over all the steps. This is fully automated and Focused RAN, and you save the full effort for it. Okay, then we're running out of time, so I will stay here a little bit longer. If you still have questions, just come to me. For the rest, thank you very much for your attention, and have a nice day.